For years now, China has been constructing their third aircraft carrier. Looking this past summer, most of the basic construction work appears finished. The 003 carrier, as it's usually called, may be launched even before the end of this year. It is the biggest carrier anyone has ever constructed, save for the US. It actually matches some older US supercarriers in size. So just what is the big deal with it? How much firepower does it add to the Chinese Navy? And how does it compare to the America's newest aircraft carrier, the USS Ford? Want to rule vast lands, raise huge armies, bomb enemies from airships? You can, as the man in the iron mask, playing Guns of Glory, which is naturally sponsoring this video. In this free-to-play game, you have to manage a city, develop it, and train troops, cavalry, cannons, even airships. The best way to play is to get chummy with other real people on the map, enter alliances, and raid, defend, and fight together. Come join Binkov's alliance. I really like the Ramparts minigame, where you're under stress to sink enemy ships. Let me tell you, those levels can get pretty hard. And the very elaborate tutorial nicely shows you the ropes and takes you into the story. Guns of Glory also celebrates its 4th anniversary with a new update, where you can attend a pirate hunt to beat Captain Bones and Sea Tyrant, get huge rewards and new skins for your airship and castle. Try the game out, download it via the link below. Use my creator code to redeem an in-game starter pack. That's for new users only though. Finally, do you want some Binkov merch? If you get Guns of Glory via my link, you will automatically enter a giveaway where you can win a Binkov plushie. Check your in-game messages for updates. Now go and give those guns a try. Let's get back to the carrier. The 003 is the China's third carrier. The first one, 001, was a Soviet Kuznetsov-class ship, finished in China. The 002 was based on the same project, with some modifications. Now this third carrier is based on a whole new design, closer to the US carrier philosophy. From the available imagery, it is very apparent that the ship is huge. Scaling it up to surroundings, it's evident the dimensions go beyond those of other countries' carriers, and rival US supercarriers of the Cold War. Note that the figures shown compare deck dimensions, not overall dimensions, as various protrusions on the Chinese carrier's deck have yet to be fully identified. The newest US carrier, the Ford class, is basically the same as the Nimitz, so the Chinese 003 trails behind it. Oh, and a big shoutout goes to Winword for his great CG renders. Deck area is pretty important for any carrier, as the bigger it is, the more operations can be performed on the deck at the same time. Of course, the size of the aircraft used matters as well, as does the manner of launching the planes, but more about that later. Displacement is an even better gauge of carrier size. During the construction process, the shape and dimensions of the waterline hull level could be compared to those of other carriers, so a rough estimate of the displacement can be attempted. Displacement-wise, the Chinese carrier is again quite comparable to the older Cold War era US supercarriers, but it does fall somewhat behind the mammoth Nimitz and Ford classes. Pitted against the Royal Navy's carrier, or Chinese own previous carrier, the 003 is much bigger. Of course, pure tonnage doesn't have to equate capability, and there are various crucial differences between the big new Chinese carrier and the US Ford class. For one, the US Ford is nuclear fueled. In such a huge ship, that's a benefit, as less room and weight have to be wasted on the ship's own fuel, meaning more room and weight available for aircraft weapon storage and aviation fuel. While figures for the Chinese carrier and Ford class are not available, here's the next best thing. Well, two things. The similarly sized Nimitz carrier, also nuclear fueled, and the CV-67 JFK, the last US conventionally powered supercarrier, which is quite similar in dimensions to the Chinese one. The Chinese carrier is almost certain to be closer to the JFK figure than to the Nimitz, or Ford figure. That's because JFK had to carry ship fuel, weighing thousands of tons. Nimitz, and thus likely Ford as well, carry almost twice as much aviation fuel and almost 50% more ordnance. Now, just how much fuel and weapons does 003 carry is impossible to know. Use doctrine may differ from that of the JFK carrier. While the US needed carriers to cross half the planet and sometimes even operate near enemy shores, it's possible that the Chinese designed their carrier to operate somewhat closer to China. Or they may plan to stick to the Indian Ocean, or perhaps not reach beyond mid-Pacific. Still, that's pure guesswork. Carriers are designed to operate for decades, so planning for just a very narrow set of missions that might change in the future may not be prudent. If the carrier is used close to China, then it might spend more time on station and less time sailing to and from replenishment zones. Lingering around Hawaii, for example, would be much more demanding, as it would have to protect its replenishment fleet. The US Ford carrier has had many technical issues reported in the media. Despite the fact it was launched in 2013 and commissioned in 2017, it has not yet performed a single deployment, because a lot of those issues are persisting. Most stem from the fact the US Navy wanted many new technologies at once, all to debut in this one ship. Electromagnetic catapults and weapon elevators, advanced arresting gear, increased automation, new radars, new nuclear reactors, and so on. Comparing such details as sortie rates, times to rearm planes, power generated, and so on with the Chinese carrier is impossible. Yet certain details on the Chinese carrier can be projected. The three catapults it uses are likely to be electromagnetic and not steam-powered, though that does need to be fully confirmed. China has been testing both steam and EM catapults for years. The images of the catapult trenches on the carrier do resemble those of EM catapults. And a lot of papers and some media claims coming out of China mention EMCAT technology as being chosen for the 003. China has been investing in electromagnetic technology like trains for decades and has even trialed an EM gun demonstrator on a ship some years ago. The role of the EM catapult is to accelerate the plane so there is less wear and tear to it, and in theory last longer between overhauls while doing it, which the US catapult has yet to achieve. While the readiness of the Chinese catapults is unknown, it is evident the ship is using three catapults, unlike the Ford's four. And unlike Ford's four per minute, the Chinese carrier may be able to launch just three planes per minute. Still, compared to the previous Chinese carrier, the 002, the catapults will enable more sorties. The Shandong carrier uses a ski jump launch method, where two fighter jets could be launched while using roughly the same deck footprint as via catapults. Third launch position did allow full weight of fuel and ordnance, but such a launch was taking up a lot of deck space and was thus interfering with other deck operations. The 003 can launch three times as many planes at maximum weight, or two times as many while interfering less with other deck ops. The 003 is a great leap from the 002 for China, approaching the Ford class in capabilities, but it is not quite yet matching it. Ford has three very large elevators, taking planes from the hangar to the main deck. 003 has two slightly smaller elevators. Each should be able to comfortably take two fighters at a time, just like the elevators on Ford. The actual number of operations per hour depends on many other factors, like parking deck space. Given that 003 is already somewhat behind Ford with its fewer catapults, but also that its deck space is fairly ample, the two elevators should not be a choke point in operations, unless one gets damaged or breaks down, which may be the main reason why US carriers do use more elevators, for redundancy. 003's command island is unusually compact, considering it also has to house the funnel for the propulsion unit. That saves it some added deck space compared to earlier Chinese carriers. It's still a bit bigger than the tiny island of the Ford, which is understandable as the nuclear-fueled Ford doesn't need the funnel space. All in all, the Chinese did seem to try to make the deck of their new carrier as large as possible. It should be able to house a fair number of aircraft, which is of course the whole point of an aircraft carrier. The 003 carrier can park approximately 2 dozen J-15 fighter-sized planes on its deck, with the landing strip, cat positions and weapons elevators all clear of planes. Ford can park approximately the same number of F-18E-sized planes on its deck under similar conditions, but it can also park some 32 or so planes if one of the catapults is not used, in which case it has three catapults free, the same number as 003. When it comes to hangar size, Ford's hangar is pretty close to Nimitz's, so it can likely hold 2 dozen Super Hornet-sized planes in there, while retaining enough room for other needs and decent plane handling rates. From the observed imagery during its build, the hangar on the Chinese carrier is narrower, possibly by as much as 15 feet. Just how long it is hard to say though. It's almost certainly longer than 002's hangar, and it might conceivably be as long as Forrestal's hangar at over 700 feet. Assuming a middle value of 610 feet long hangar, basically just an elongated and slightly wider 002 design, the Chinese carrier should also be able to house nearly two dozen J-15 sized fighters. Of course, the J-15 is the current Chinese carrier-borne fighter. Right now, a variant not suitable to catapult launches is being used on Liaoning and Shandong, but a different variant has been tested. It's almost certain that 003 will see the catapult-capable variant by the middle of this decade. Sometime by the end of the decade, China will also add a stealthy fighter to its 003 carrier. Its development is already underway, based on the Project 31 demonstrator from years ago. So how many aircraft will the Chinese carrier use? The theoretical values mentioned earlier are a rough guideline, but are still not exact. There are other types of aircraft and handling equipment requiring space as well. Who's to tell how much space will 6th generation planes take up? An aerial early warning radar plane will easily take up space of one combat plane, and China has been developing such planes. While the previous carriers used helicopters for early warning, 003 will feature a custom-designed plane, the KJ-600. In most regards, it's very similar in size, class and likely capabilities to the new US Navy E-2 Hawkeyes. Due to likely operational use near the Chinese coast, the 003 will likely need fewer such planes than the US carriers, operating far from their bases. Electronic warfare variant of J-15, the D variant, similar to the US Growler, has also been in development, so it's likely those will also see service on the 003. The Ford carriers are very likely to have a mixed air wing of Super Hornets and the newer stealthy F-35Cs. Also, the US Navy is in the initial stages of developing the Super Hornet successor, a 6th generation fighter that might start filling the decks of US carriers in the mid-2030s. Various helicopters and other planes complete the air wings of two carrier types, for search and rescue, utility and onboard delivery roles, and anti-submarine warfare. The US Ford will also have some dedicated tanker drones, the MQ-25s. The likely aircraft composition of both carriers around the year 2025 should be as shown. The figures are approximate. Still, the bigger Ford will carry more aircraft. While the figures may seem low compared to what the US carriers had on board in past decades, the numbers are a result of a change in doctrine, where not crowding the ship with planes results in better operational tempos. If the need arises, both ships could probably add several to a dozen more combat planes for short periods, with Ford likely capable of handling more than the 003. On to propulsion. The 003, being heavier than the 002, will most likely feature improved and more powerful boilers, likely resulting in far more power. Its boilers would be burning oil, unlike Ford, which uses a nuclear reactor. The rest of the power plant is similar in both ships. Steam is created, and then steam turbines turn the shafts. As with Kuznetsov, Liaoning and Shandong, the 003 is not likely to quite reach the top speeds of the Ford. But for the great majority of ops, those few knots of speed difference will not matter much. Both Ford and 003 seem to have fairly comprehensive suite of modern radar arrays, though exact capabilities are not known. When it comes to self-protection, the US Ford uses a broader set of weapons. Its anti-missile defenses are made up of the medium-range ESSM missiles. The second layer is the shorter-ranged rolling airframe missile system. The last layer features Phalanx Gatling guns, though their 20mm caliber and rate of fire may make them inadequate against supersonic missiles. The 003's defenses are not yet known, as the carrier isn't completed, but they are likely to at least match those of the previous Chinese carrier. So far, no system similar to the US ESSM has been observed in testing. For now, we will assume the 003 will not have that medium-range defense layer, but it's still likely to use at least three HQ-10 systems, which should be very similar in capabilities to the US rolling airframe missile system, as well as at least three big 11-barrel 30mm Gatling guns. Being a larger caliber and having more than double the fire rate of the US Phalanx, those would likely do better than Phalanxes against anti-ship missiles. The process of building a carrier and actually putting it to service is of course long. Launching the ship means all the big items have been put in place and the hull can float. But even after the launch, there will likely be 2 or so years of fitting out the ship. It will be parked in a different location in the yard, floating with various subsystems and installations being gradually added. So sometime in 2023 or 2024, the ship may embark on its first trial. If there aren't any major issues with it, the ship will likely be commissioned into Chinese service. So likely by 2025. But that doesn't mean it will be ready for deployments. That depends on ironing out many kinks, training the crew and simply getting familiar with this brand new kind of a weapon system. The actual active service may not begin before 2026 or even 2027, a few years after the first four-class ship finally undertakes its first active deployment. The 003 will not reach the capability of the Ford carrier, nor even the Nimitz, but that's not the point. One-on-one carrier comparisons miss the greater context, one of a complex battlefield with many systems working in unison, trying to overcome the specifics of the battlefield and its geography. In that regard, the 003 represents a big leap in Chinese capabilities. It offers brand new options to the Chinese fleet. While its previous carriers were baby steps in development, based on Soviet designs, this new carrier may be seen as the ship ushering the Chinese Navy into a new era.